First story today, Taiwan's export value of semiconductor-based components has experienced a monthly decline for three consecutive months. China Credit Information Service has warned that Taiwan will suffer from the impact of U.S. sanctions on semiconductor exports to China in the first quarter of this year.
The fourth quarter peak season in 2022 was not busy. Taiwan's exports have experienced negative growth for three consecutive months. The Ministry of Finance will announce the import and export figures for December 2022 on the 7th. It is inevitable that there will be four consecutive months of negative growth. China Credit Information Service warned that Taiwan's export value may decline to between 435 and 452.5 billion U.S. dollars this year, a rate of between 5% and 9.1% due to U.S. sanctions on semiconductor exports to China. Exports of electronic components and audiovisual products will further bottom out.
11月的这个内需是衰退了超过5%来看啊，那今年第一季台湾对中国大陆在特别是在这个电子零组件以及自通讯产品的这个衰退都可能会出现一个持续扩大的一个情况，所以我们大概预计2023年台湾对中国大陆的出口衰退会在5%-8%之间。
Taiwan and South Korea's semiconductor exports have been damaged by the U.S. and China trip war. The Fed's aggressive interest rate hike in 2022 led to nearly 70% of large U.S. institutions believing that an economic recession is coming for the country. The Federal Reserve is expected to stop raising interest rates in the second quarter. However, from the minutes of the Fed's December meeting, officials emphasized their determination to fight inflation. The Fed has not weakened its determination to achieve stable prices after raising rates by 0.75% three times and then 0.5%. It does not consider inflation to be slowing down.
当美元或者是美国开始升息，对美国的家庭来讲，譬如说像手机啦、笔电啊、脚踏车等等，这些非必要性的消费产品呢，有很多就是我们亚洲国家那个出口的主力啊，美国升息的时候，那个第一波影响到的很可能就是它的进口产品。
When will the Fed end its strong interest rate hikes? Scholars believe that two indicators must be observed. U.S. monetary policy may shift when the U.S. inflation rate falls below 5% and the unemployment rate exceeds 5%. Then an interest rate cut is possible. The global economy may likely recover slowly and offer growth opportunities for Taiwanese exports.